Okay, you guys seem to enjoy my last workout so much. I'm sitting on a rower right now. And you asked me to do another one, so I'm posting a new workout today. Today's workout is going to be a barbell complex workout. So I'm gonna be doing 5 different exercises using a barbell. Some of them are exercises you probably might not have seen before because I have made them up, but we're gonna be hitting legs, we're gonna be hitting upper body, getting some cardio in there, increasing our heart rate. Today I'm gonna be filming in a brand new gym. It's called SWAT. It literally just opened like a few weeks ago, like 10 minutes away from my house. It's perfect. So you guys are gonna get to see how amazing this gym is. And other than that, make sure you get a really good warm-up in. I'm gonna be doing like a 5 to 10 minute warm-up, starting with some running and a bunch of dynamic stretches. So I'll get some shots of that as well. Okay, so I just set up my barbell. I put 15 pounds on each side, so the total weight is going to be 75 pounds. I knew that. This is a bit of an advanced workout, so if you're not comfortable using a barbell, just switch it up for the dumbbells and just try to do what you can. All right, let's get to it. So for this first exercise, I actually snagged it from Whitney Simmons. It's one of my favorite. The first time I did it, I was like, yes, this is a great exercise. I'm going to add this into my routines. So it's a 1¾ squat. Place the barbell on your traps or wherever it feels most comfortable, unless you're using dumbbells, then hold them up by your shoulders. Squat down fully, keeping your toes slightly pointed out. When you come down to 90 degrees, come up about halfway before coming back down into a full squat. Push through your heels again and extend all the way to the top, squeezing your glutes. You should feel this in your glutes almost immediately, but especially by the end of the 10 reps, your glutes will be on fire. If you have never done this exercise before, I would suggest just starting with the barbell without adding weight on. And doing this exercise is almost like a pulsing motion, so your quads will get tired pretty quickly. You want to have good form, so make sure that the weight is something that you can definitely push. The next exercise is a hang clean. If you've never done this exercise before, not to worry, you don't have to try it now. You can modify by doing box jumps or weighted burpees instead. I don't want this to turn into an informational session on how to do a hang clean because there are so many aspects to it. So if you're going to do this exercise, I'm going to assume you already have done this before. I like to add this to the workout because it's a very explosive and powerful movement. By the end of the 10 reps, I was gassed. In my second and third sets, I wasn't able to do 10 reps in a row, so instead I did a set of 5 and then another set of 5. Do whatever works for you as long as you're maintaining the correct form and not just trying to muscle through the exercise. If your heart rate wasn't up already from those last 2 exercises, it definitely will be after this one. You're going to be hopping over the barbell, but as you land on the other side, you're going to be doing 3 high knees. It should work out so that the knee closest to the barbell is raised at a 90-degree angle, ready to go straight into the next rep. Standing on that one leg is a lot easier than it looks. You're going to have to be activating your glutes, your core, and keeping your body nice and tall to hold that position. As you jump over and do your high knees, make sure you're driving your knees as high as you can, not being lazy, not slacking on this exercise at all. You're going for 10 reps, but 1 rep is jumping on both sides of the barbell with 3 high knees on each side. So if you do the math, that's 3 times 2 times 10, which is 60 high knees. You'll be doing 60 high knees in total. The next exercise you're going to be doing is a push press, and this is the exercise where you get to make all the pretty faces that you want. Grip the barbell and let it rest on your shoulders and collarbones. Bend your knees slightly, and using that power, push the barbell up and over your head. You're going to be driving your heels into the ground and make sure you're engaging your core. Your elbows should be locked out at the top, and your entire body should be sturdy. If you find that the barbell is wobbling around over your head and you don't have control, drop down the weight. It's so important to have control during this exercise as you don't want to injure yourself. Again, if you haven't tried this exercise before, use dumbbells to begin. Breathe out as you push the weight up and try to get all 10 reps in a row. This is definitely more of an upper body focused exercise, but I promise you, you will feel it through your entire body. This is the second to last exercise. You have one more and then you're done the circuit. Okay, last one. This is a squat jump over the barbell and then you're walking back, keeping your body nice and low, knees bent. As you jump over, land directly into a squat position, keeping your knees at a 90 degree angle. Staying low, walk your left foot over the bar and then your right, coming back to your starting position. Make sure the weight is distributed throughout your entire foot. You're not just balancing on the balls of your feet. Jump over again, landing firmly and controlled, except this time when you walk back over, use the opposite foot to begin. Repeat for 10 reps, staying nice and low the entire time and never standing fully up. Your quads will be burning by the end of this, and it's a great way to end the circuit. So that's the last exercise on the circuit. You're gonna rest for 2 minutes and then repeat it for 2 more times total.
It's bright. Okay, I've done 2 sets of that circuit. I'm gonna go for a third. And then I'm gonna jump on my favorite, slash not favorite at all, piece of equipment, which is the assault bike, and I'm gonna do a quick little intense, I don't know, burnout on there. So one last circuit and then hit the bike. Let's do this. Done 3 sets, off to the assault bike. Okay, so the assault bike is completely optional. If you just want to push yourself a little bit more, I'd suggest doing it. If you're done from that barbell workout, it's pretty tough, so if you're done, end it there, go do a cool down. If you want to get 5 more minutes in, let's hop on the bike.
Alrighty, the assault bike or the Airdyne, whatever the thing is that blows air in your face as you're biking and makes your hair look insane. I just made something up on the fly. What I did was 5 rounds. I did 20 seconds of full out sprint. And when I say sprint, I mean like ugly face sprint. 20 seconds of that and then a 40 second slower pace bike. So it's 20 seconds hard, 40 seconds technically off, but you're still moving your legs, you're still moving your arms. And I did that for 5 times total. So that was just a quick 5 minute additional workout. And then I was finished.
And now today.
Oh, this is Kyle, the owner of this magnificent gym.
Hello.
This Dave. Is Dr. Dave.
And another owner.
It's like, oh, it looks pretty good.
Thank you very much.
Chicken
eggs.
Look at that. Okay, I'm done. I have to take a knee. So, I ended up doing 20 seconds on, 40 seconds off, 5 times for a good 5 minute burnout. As you can see, pretty tired. So yeah, that concludes this workout. Make sure you get an awesome stretch in. Drink some protein, drink lots of water. Until next time.